And the two districts that have been selected from Jharkhand were Khunti and Hazaribagh. The reason for selecting these districts were because in 2015, the government of Jharkhand has launched a new program for promoting the adoption of cross-breeding amongst the tribal women so that they can empower them for getting extra additional income for their household and even for getting supplement for their food requirement because Jharkhand is not a milk consuming state as you all know. It is just a state which has just come up from the lowest of the Indian states and in milk it is not the part of our consumption, but due to the development of the state and due to the development in the people, growth in the income of the people, now they are shifting from the normal consumption of rice, wheat to the nutritional supplements for themselves. So this study was taken under consideration because in Jharkhand, not much study has been done for agriculture or the allied sectors. So the flow of presentation will be introduction about the scheme, then data and the methodology, then the result and discussion, last will be the conclusion. So for the introduction part, the Jharkhand. Yes, sir. So in India, about 90% of the milk production is concentrated in the 14 states, in which the top 5 are the Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh. The eastern region, that is the plains of Assam, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, eastern Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Odisha and West Bengal, they represent 21.85% of the geographical area, but they support 33% of the population of India. Jharkhand is one of the major states formed in 2000 and it contributes nearly to the 3.5% of the total livestock population with 1.19% of milk production in the country. Coming up next, the average productivity of milk animals in Jharkhand is far below than the national average, that is 4.4, and the national average is 5 kgs per day. The cross-fed population in the state is 3.93% of the total cattle population. So about 3% of the milk producing animals in the Jharkhand are, maximum, that is 93% of the milk producing animals in Jharkhand are nondescript. So the dairy animals, especially the crossbred, suffer from nutritional deficiencies and infertility because of the non-availability of better quality of substrates and cattle feeds and poor management facilities. So in 2015-16, as I said earlier, the government of Jharkhand launched a new program for the BPL women to provide them crossbred cows with 90% subsidy to boost up the milk production in the state and to improve the economic condition of the women farmers in particular. So, next slide please. Okay. So, for this data collection, 130 farmers were selected and from these two districts and traditionally, the technological component can be divided into two parts. The technological component is divided into neutral and the non-neutral part. So the neutral part comprises of the change in the intercept form because of the change in the technology. And the non-neutral form is because of the change in the slope parameter of the existing graph. So the crossbred population, so what we did here, that we took data from 130 households the respondents, they were having at least one crossbred cow in their cattle herd size. So we took data for crossbred cows and for the local bred cows. Next slide please. Okay, so we took cob produce production function. This was the production function that was taken into consideration. The dependent variable was the milk yield, and the independent variables were the dry fodder, green fodder, concentrates, and the labor and the veterinary expenses that were done for both for cross-fed cows and for local cows. Next slide, please. So the neutral and non-neutral variance of the technological efficiency.
Okay. I know you here, this is your analysis, quite collaborative. You need at least 1 hour to speak on the various parameters. But I think you also learn to say what I want to say in high school. I just come to your results and everything.
Coming up to the results and conclusion.
Go ahead.
So the first table was the OLS estimates of the various parameters. The first column gives us the different independent variables, and the second column was for the cross-fed cows, and the third one was the local cows. As we can see that the constant term for the cross-fed cows is quite large and significant. It shows that there is higher efficiency of milk production for the cross-fed cows in comparison to the local breeds. We can see that the dry fodder and the dry fodder and the other components, independent variables, they were negative, and so they were not considered. But for the labor, it was positive. So it was considered that it is giving certain significant amount of effect on the milk yield. For the crossbred, the independent variables were able to represent 75% of the variation in the milk yield, and for the local cows it was 97%. The next table was for the geometric mean. The geometric mean was taken for each factors to find out the difference in the input supplied for the two different technologies that were taken into consideration, that was the crossbred cow and the local cow. You can see here the labor expenses is like 12 times more than the crossbred cow, which is significant from the earlier table, the regression table that was shown before. This is the decomposition analysis. So we can see here that the change in yield was around 85%, out of which the contribution of technological change was 72%, and the non-neutral technological change was 100. We can see that the contribution of technological change was much more than the non-neutral technological change, which suggests that the the mere existence of the change in technology from local cows to cross-fed cows was much more beneficial than the change in inputs, because the farmers, they were not able to reap out the change in inputs that were to be given. That was basically because of the farmers were not feeding the exact or recommended level of diet. They were feeding it just because the crossbreds need more of concentrates and green fodder. So it was just because they were not even skilled in feeding. So they were just feeding for the sake of feeding. They were not adopting the recommended levels of feed. So there was a slight discrepancy. But still it was clear that the crossbred cows were yielding more, and the remunerative price was also more for the crossbred milk rather than the local cows.
Yes, sir.
So actually my emphasis was in Jharkhand, so I missed out Punjab there.
Karma of the other states, sir. I have learned everything.
So, any other observation, question, or comment?